Hello friends, good morning to all of you. Today we are going to study the first chapter of geometry whose name is similarity. Friends, in the last lecture we have studied that the property of ratio of areas of two triangles. We know that there are four properties of ratio of areas of two triangles. The first property was that the ratio of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights is equal to the product of their bases and corresponding heights. The second property was that the ratio of areas of two triangles having equal bases is equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights. The third property is that the ratio of areas of two triangles having equal heights is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. And the fourth property is that the ratio of areas of two triangles having equal bases and equal heights is 1:1. That is, their areas are equal. Friends, we have studied three properties. First three properties of ratio of areas of two triangles. And I have given you the proofs of these three statements in the last period. And now fourth property, having the ratio of areas of two triangles having equal bases and equal heights. Try to write the proof of the fourth statement, fourth property yourself. And if you are unable to write the proof of this fourth statement or fourth property, then you can pause this and write the answer. Now in this period, we are going to study about the practice set 1.1. There are some problems in practice set 1.1 which are depending upon the property of ratio of areas of two triangles. Four properties of ratio of areas of two triangles. Right. Now the first problem is that the base of a triangle is 9 and height is 5 cm. Base of another triangle is 10 and height is 6 cm. Then find the ratio of areas of these triangles. Now we want to find out the ratio of areas of two triangles. We know that there are four properties. There are four types of ratio of areas of two triangles. We must, first of all, we must confirm that which type of that two triangles, whether the triangles having different bases and different heights, whether the triangles having equal bases, whether the triangles having equal heights, whether the triangles having equal heights and equal bases. Here are the two triangles whose bases and heights are different. Means the base of first triangle is 9 and height is 5 cm. And the base of second triangle is 10 cm and is 10 units and height is 6 units. Now we want to find out the ratio of areas of two triangles. Now I am going to write the answer here. Let A1, B1, H1 and A2, B2, S2 are the area, base and height of the first and second triangle respectively. Right. Now A1 equal to find out. B1 equal to base of first triangle is 9 units. H1 equal to height of the first triangle is 5 units. Now A2, area of second triangle, we want to find out. Question mark, right? B2, base of the second triangle, it is 10 units. And height of the second triangle, it's 6 units. Now these two triangles are having different bases and different heights. And understand? And we know that the ratio of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights is equal to the product of product of the ratio of their bases and corresponding heights. Now I am using that property. Here are the two triangles having different bases and here are the these triangles are having different bases. Different heights. Now, by using the property of ratio of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights. We know the property of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights. The ratio of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights is equal to the ratio of product of their bases and corresponding heights. That is why, therefore, area of first triangle divided by area of second triangle is equals to, this is the ratio of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights, is equal to the ratio of product of their bases and corresponding heights, b1 into h1 divided by b2 into h2, right? Now substitute the values. Now a1 divided by a2 equal to b1, it's 9, h1 it's 5, divided by b2 it's 10, h1 is 6, right? Now 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6. Now give the simplest form, we get a1 by a2 is equals to A1 by A2 equal to 3 by 4, right? We can write the answer in full sentence. We get, therefore, the ratio of areas of two triangles, is 3:4, right? Pause this and write down. Now, second example is that on the board in figure, BC is perpendicular to AB. BC is perpendicular to AB and ED is perpendicular to AB. BC equal to 4 and AD equal to 8. Then find the area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle ADB. First of all, we must confirm that whether these two triangles are having equal bases and equal heights, whether these triangles are having equal heights, whether these triangles are different heights and different bases. Which types of these two triangles are? First of all, confirm that. Now, look at this figure. We get in triangle ABC, AB is the base and BC is its height. And in triangle BAD, AB is the base and AD is height. Means the segment BD is common in these two triangles. And AB is the base of these two triangles. Means these two triangles are having common bases or equal bases. And if the base of two triangles are equal, then the ratio of areas of these two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights. Now I am going to write here answer. It is very easy. In triangle ABC and triangle ADB, segment AB is the common base. Say AB is the common base or equal base, you can write. Therefore, by the property of property of ratio of areas of two triangles, having equal bases, because they have a common base, understand? Therefore, area of triangle ABC, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle ADB equal to ratio of the respective triangles equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights, because they have a common base or equal base. Understand? Ratio of their corresponding heights. Which is the height of triangle ABC? BC is the height of triangle ABC. And which is the height of triangle ADB? AD is the height of triangle ADB. Now substitute the values. We get BC equal to 4 and AD it's 8. Now view the simplest form. We get 4 1 is 4, 4 2 is 8. Means, therefore, area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle ADB equal to 1 by 2, right? Pause the video and write down answer. Now, what is here in the third example? In the adjoining figure, sag PS is perpendicular to sag RQ. Sag PS is perpendicular to sag RQ. And sag QT is perpendicular to sag PR. Right. RQ equal to 6. So, RQ equal to 6. PS equal to 6. PR equal to 12. And we want to find out QT. To find out the QT, we must know the base and area of the triangle PQR. Means area of triangle is equals to 1 by 2 into base into height is the formula for finding area of triangles. If we want to find out the area, then we must know base and height. If we want to find out the base, then we must know that area and height. If we want to find out the height, then we must area and base. Here, we want to find out QT. QT means the height of triangle PQR. Right, QT is the height of triangle PQR. To find the height, we must know area and base, understand? For that, we must know whether PR is the base. Yes, PR is the base. And it is 12, base is given. But we don't know the area. But we can find the area by another way, understand? By considering sag RQ is the base and sag PS is its height, we get the area of triangle PQR. And in this way, we can find the height of triangle PQR by considering base PR, understand? Now, first of all, find the area of triangle PQR by considering sag RQ as a base. Area of triangle in triangle PQR. Area of triangle equal to 1 by 2 into base into height. Right. Means area of triangle PQR equal to 1 by 2 base. RQ is the base and height, PS is the height. RQ is the base and PS is its height, right? Now substitute the values, we get 1 by 2 into RQ. How much RQ? It is 6 and PS is 6. 1 by 2 into 6 into 6. 6 6 is 36. 2 1 is 2, 2 1 is 2, 2 8 is 16. Therefore, we get 18 square units. 18 square units is the area of triangle PQR. Now we can find the area of triangle, we can find the length of QT. Understand? By considering CLPR as the base. Understand? Now area of triangle PQR equal to 1 by 2 into base. PR is the base. PR is the base and QT is its height. By considering say PR as base. Right. We get area of triangle PUR, we know that it is 80 equal to 1 by 2. PR, it is square. Understand? Into QT, right? Now 2 on the 2, 2 6 the 12. Means 18 equal to 6 into QT, right? Now 18, take this 6 at left hand side, we get 18 by 6 equal to QT, right? 6 on the 6, 6 3 the 18. 6 3 the 18. Therefore, QT equal to 3 units. This is the answer. Understand? Pause the screen and write the answer. Now in the fourth example, in adjoining figure, AP is perpendicular to BC. AP is perpendicular to BC. And AD is parallel to BC. Then find area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle BCD. Area of triangle ABC and triangle BCD is there. BCD. Area of triangle BCD. Understand? Now, first of all confirm which are the base and heights of these two triangles. Whether these two triangles are having different bases, different heights, or equal bases, equal heights, or what? In triangle ABC, BC is the base and AP is its height. And triangle DBC, BC is the base and we don't know the height. To find the height, we must draw the perpendicular segment from D. On side BC, we get draw seg DQ. Perpendicular to side BC. In answer, draw seg DQ perpendicular to the side BC. Now in triangle ABC, BC is the base and AP is its height. And in triangle DBC, BC is the base and DC, DQ is its height. Now these two triangles are having equal bases in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC and triangle BCD, say BC is the common base, understand, or equal base, right? Now AD and DQ are the two heights. But these are the two perpendicular segments, perpendicular distances between the two parallel lines. And we know that the perpendicular distance between two parallel lines is constant. The perpendicular distance between two parallel lines is constant. Or these two triangles are bounded by parallel lines. Means in triangle ABC and triangle DBC, base BC is the common base. AP is perpendicular to BC and DQ is perpendicular to BC. Means these two triangles are bounded by parallel lines. They have the common base and these two triangles are bounded by parallel lines. Therefore, their heights are equal. Or we can say that AP equal to DQ. Why? Because these are the perpendicular distances between parallel lines. The perpendicular distances between two parallel lines are same. Understand? Say line AD is parallel to line BC.
Therefore, we say that AP equal to DQ. Why AP equal to DQ? Because these are the triangles having, AP equal to DQ because AP and DQ are the heights, AP and DQ are the perpendicular distances between the parallel lines. The perpendicular distances, I am going to write the reason here, the perpendicular distances between two parallel are equal. Understand? Therefore, these two triangles are having equal bases and equal heights. Therefore, by the property of ratio of areas of two triangles, having equal bases and equal heights. Means their areas are equal, or the ratio of these two triangles is 1:1. Means area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle BCD equals to 1:1, right? In this way, we can see that therefore area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle BCD equal to 1:1. This is the answer. Understand?
Pause the screen and write the answer. This is the fifth example and last example of practice set 1.1. Now in the adjoining figure, PQ is perpendicular to BC. And AD is perpendicular to BC. Then find the following ratios. First ratio is area of triangle PQB divided by area of triangle PBC. In triangle PQB, BQ is the base and PQ is its height. And in triangle PBC, BC is base and PQ is its height. This means that the height of these two triangles are equal or common. Therefore, the ratio of areas of these two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. Understand? Now, I am going to write here answer. In triangle PQB and triangle PBC, say PQ is the common height. Therefore, by the property of ratio of areas of two triangles, having equal heights, we get area of triangle PQB divided by area of triangle PBC. Means the ratio of the two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. Which is the base of triangle first triangle? BQ is the base of first triangle. And which is the base of second triangle? BC is the base of second triangle. This is the answer of the first ratio. Now in triangle PBC and ABC, in triangle PBC and triangle ABC,
Sec BC is the common base. Therefore, these triangles are having equal bases. The ratio of areas of two triangles having equal bases is equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights. Now, I am going to write here. Sec BC is the common base. Sec BC is the common base. Therefore, the ratio of areas of two triangles, ratio of areas of two triangles having equal bases, we get the answer. Area of triangle PBC divided by area of triangle ABC equal to, which is the height of first triangle PBC, PQ is the height of first triangle, and in triangle ABC, AD is the height of second triangle, right? Means the ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding heights. Understand? Because their bases are equal or common. Now we want to find out the third ratio. Understand? In triangle ABC and ADC. In triangle ABC, BC is the base and AD is its height. And in triangle ADC, DC is the base and AD is its height. Means in these two triangles, Sec AD is the common height of these two triangles. Therefore, the ratio of areas of these two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases, because they have a common height or equal height. Understand? Now, I am going to write here the answer. In triangle, third example, in triangle ABC and triangle ADC, right? Sec AD is the common height. Sec AD is the common height, right? Therefore, by the property of ratio of areas of two triangles, by the property of ratio of areas of two triangles having equal heights, we get area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle ADC is equal to the ratio of areas of two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases, because they have a common height or equal height. Understand? Means area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle ADC is equal to, which is the base of first triangle ABC, BC is the base of first triangle BC, and which is the base of second triangle ADC, DC is the base of second triangle, right? Now this is the answer of third ratio. Now I am going to write the answer of fourth ratio. ADC and PQC. In triangle ADC, DC is the base and AD is the heights. In triangle QC is the base and PQ its height. Right. In triangle ADC and triangle PQC, right? In triangle ADC and triangle PQC, bases and heights are different. Therefore, area of triangle ADC divided by area of triangle PQC equal to the ratio of areas of two triangles having different bases and different heights is equal to the product of is equal to the ratio of product of their bases and corresponding heights, which is the base of first triangle ADC, DC is the base of first triangle, and which is the height, AD is the height of first triangle, right? And which is the base of second triangle PQC? QC is the base of first second triangle. And which is the height? PQ is the height. Right. Okay, by the property of ratio of areas of two triangles, having different bases and different heights. Pause the video and write the answer. Friends, in this way, we have completed the practice set 1.1. Now you can try to solve the all 5 problems on the blank pages. Thank you.